Hello, YouTubers. I'm EF86 here. And I'm just curious, and so I'm going to take my NES apart. There it is right there. I have a bunch of screwdrivers and stuff. It's just right here. It works fine. I'm just curious to see what's inside it and everything. Now, I'm not going to tinker around in it. I'm just going to just look inside it maybe. I don't know. I don't know what I'll do. We'll see. Let's just hope it still works when I put it back together, so pray for that. Okay, we're gonna use the screwdriver because it fits all these. It's a whatever you call it, Phillips head, I guess. I'm not a screwdriver expert, so. Alright. The good thing about this Nintendo, because it doesn't have those annoying screws. Oh, here. Super Nintendo over here. I looked at my Super Nintendo to take apart, but no, it has some annoying looking screws down there. You can't use them with any screwdriver except a special one you have to get online. But the original Nintendo has regular Phillips screws or whatever, so that's good. So we're going to start taking it apart. I will be back later. Okay, so I did get the back loose. Here's the three screws that went to the back, like this part. As you can see, I guess that's the cartridge drive. Do you call that a drive? Well, I think that's just for CDs. I don't know. Gotta get these front three screws off or whatever. I don't know. I'll just go ahead and do that for you. I probably unscrew them, but that's a bit more. This one right here. Right. One, two. Oh, it's open. All right, here. It's open. And behold, inside of the NES. There it is, right there, all for you. Here's the cover of it here, the door. Wow, there's nothing there. Wow. Nothing, no wires or anything inside. Yep, that's pretty much it. All right, enough about that. Here's some screws. We need to keep these. Let's keep them in here. That's a good place. All right, here it is. The inside of one of the greatest systems you will ever. I got this from a friend, so let's see how everything in condition is. I think they call these toaster appliance, toaster dry, toaster cartridge drive or whatever. Whatever. Yeah. There's the drive for it. I'm not gonna take out this because I'm afraid something will break or something. You can see many, many colored wires. There's some circuit board things, parts. I'm guessing that's a battery. There's some audio video ports right there. Here's some RF and power and stuff. Here's the things that go to the controller. See, controller ports. Oh, there's another screw. Here we have power and reset button. You can see it right there. There's the LED. This clear thing right there is the LED. I wonder if I could turn it on like this, just like with the cover off. Huh. I don't know. Should I try it? I don't know. Well, I would have to take this off to see all of it inside and stuff. I don't know. It's kind of, I don't know, is that rusted or what? I don't know what that is. It's something. I don't think it's going to affect the gameplay, though. You know what? I think I am going to take these screws out. I think I'm just going to do that. I hope nothing bad will happen. See, and do this, I'm just dying. I want someone to sniper. Or, you know, on a computer. I'm not doing here. I think that is. Alright, we got all the screws taken out here, so let's raise it up and see. Oh, the power's on here. Let's see. Wow, it's just this. I guess this is what it looks like inside here. Oh, there's some more screws. Should I take stuff out? It wouldn't hurt, I don't think. Would it? I don't know. I'm afraid to do it. You can see a little bit more of the circuit board right there. So there's a 72-pin connector. I don't know when I'll have to replace. Hopefully not soon, because I don't know where to get one. You know, I don't think it's going to hurt it if I unscrew this and take it out. So let's do that. Just that's the last thing I'll do. I think we'll get to the actual innards. Okay, I just looked it up on this video, and this guy just lifted and slided it out. I was kind of afraid to lift it, but I did. This is apparently the bottom of the motherboard, because the motherboard, I guess it's upside down. Is it supposed to be like that? But here's the actual part. There's the 72-pin connector. I'm not sure how I'm going to put this back in. I hope I'll be able to do that. I'm really scared if this will work or not. Let's see here. Nothing much. Just a green board with lines, motherboard in there. Well, there is this. There's a brown thing under there that says 1985 Nintendo. So, all right, I'm going to attempt to reassemble it. All right, after like 10 minutes, I finally got these back in. This heat, whatever. Alright, well, looks like I'm gonna have to close it back up. The only thing I have to put back is the case. All these screws down here. I just hope there's no leftover screws, because if there is, I know I forgot to do something, and then I'll have to go back in, which I'm not going to do again, because I'm afraid. I'm scared enough already that it might not work when I plug it in and stuff. I don't know. We'll have to see. Well, screw the case back in. We're going to hook my NES up to the TV. We're going to put in Super Mario Brothers and turn the switch on, and hopefully something will happen. Oh boy, Super Mario Brothers. We don't even need a controller. Let's just open it up. Put it in. My heart is racing right now. Okay, it actually went down. Turn on television. Here's the static. Turn it on. What the heck's wrong with it? That is not good. It's not even turning on. Okay, we have it. Turn it on. It works! It freaking works. Oh, thank God. I guess it was just the power strip I was using in there. I plugged it in the living room. It works. Thank you. Thank you, God above. That is freaking relief. Okay. I gotta go take a pill. Alright, well, that's about it. Took apart my NES. Never doing it again, though. Yeah, that's it.